There is a fifth dimension beyond that which is known to man. It is a dimension as vast as space and as timeless as infinity. It is the middle ground between light and shadow, between science and superstition, and it lies between the pit of man's fears and the summit of his knowledge. This is the dimension of imagination. It is an area which we call the owl stretching zone. Submitted for your approval. A glimpse into the future. Not a future that will be, but one that might be. This is not a new world, just an extension of what began in the old one.
Bring in the next defendant!
Right away, Sir Chancellor.
Next defendant, Macaluso Frank. Obsolescence.
Approach the bench, Mr. Macaluso.
Okay.
Ahem!
Oh, right away, your chancellorship?
You are to address me as Sir Chancellor.
Sorry, it's my first time.
Enough idle banter. Approach the bench.
Yes, Sir Chancellor.
Now, Mr. Macaluso, do you know why you are here?
Yes, sir, I have been made aware of why I'm here.
You've been under investigation, Mr. Macaluso, for the mandatory period of 1 year and 11 months. You've been found obsolete by the field investigators in your sector. The purpose of this hearing is to make a finding in the matter and sentence you accordingly. Do you understand that?
Yes, sir.
Now, state your occupation.
I'm an actor, sir.
What?
Tell me he's not serious. A what?
An actor, sir. And a writer, primarily for theater and radio, sir.
Has this man had counsel?
Yes, he has, Sir Chancellor.
Has he been given orientation?
Yes, he has, sir.
Ah. Mr. Macaluso, I've been told that you've been given counsel before this hearing, and yet I am still not sure you fully understand the nature of this hearing. You've been classified as obsolete, Mr. Macaluso, and that carries with it serious implications. Do you understand that?
I do, sir.
Very well. I ask you again, what is your occupation?
I am an actor and writer in the fields of theater and radio. If you all think that makes me obsolete, then...
Request clarification of the term.
Yes. Mr. Macaluso, when you say you all, is this in reference to the state?
Yes, sir. It is in reference to the state.
Actually, Sir Chancellor, I was seeking clarification of the term actor. Is it merely one who commits an act? Or is there a specific action performed by the individual?
Ah, well, for the benefit of the court, an actor is defined by the state as one who performs in plays or vignettes, often taking on a persona other than their own. Since there are no more theaters, there is very little call for an actor or a playwright, making both occupations obsolete.
But radio still exists.
The state has seen it fit to continue to allow the use of airwaves for the distribution of information. And the distribution of information alone. It is controlled completely by the state, and the state sees no value in fictional works.
Yeah.
Silence! Now, the state is aware of some smaller pirate radio stations that continue to indulge in broadcasting dramas and music, and spreading salacious falsehoods about the state. But those small stations are very quickly being shut down, at a rate of about 200 a day. You, of course, have chosen not to divulge the location of the station for which you worked, or any of your colleagues in deception.
I have no desire to betray my friends.
Friends? I haven't a doubt in my mind that if we were to have tracked down any one of your friends, before we had gotten you, they would have sold you out in a heartbeat! Anything to prolong their bleak, miserable lives. Up yours! That turn of phrase, Mr. Macaluso, in addition to being completely disrespectful and unbecoming of a citizen of the state, is outdated and obsolete, perhaps even more than you are. You are a relic, Mr. Macaluso, an anachronism, a pathetic little square peg for whom no holes exist. You are a waste of our time, Mr. Macaluso, and you are not worth the waste. The forewoman of the jury is instructed to step forward. How does the jury find?
Sir Chancellor, we find the defendant, Frank Gifford Macaluso, to be obsolete.
I concur. Mr. Macaluso, the jury has found you obsolete.
Yeah, I heard.
Silence! Your rights, which I begrudgingly allow you to keep, are as follows. You are to be liquidated within a period of 48 hours, but you have an option as to method and precise time. There are several prescribed methods, Mr. Macaluso. Pills, gas, electrocution. And it can be done immediately, or an hour from now, or any specific time you request.
Is that so, huh? I'd like to have an assassin to whom I will tell the method of my execution.
What? Sir Chancellor, this is unheard of.
Mr. Macaluso, we don't understand the nature of this request.
Basically, you assign me an assassin, and only they and I are gonna know how I'm gonna die.
We deem your requested method of execution to be acceptable, Mr. Macaluso, provided that you are indeed liquidated within the 48-hour period.
Neat. Oh, there is one other thing. I would like to die with an audience.
Ah, that can be arranged, Mr. Macaluso. It's not unusual that we televise executions. It has an educative effect on the population.
Don't I know it.
Now, as to the time of the liquidation, Mr. Macaluso.
9 o'clock tomorrow evening, sir.
And the place?
My apartment.
Very well, then. Your execution shall be carried out exactly as you've requested. That will be all now. You may leave and return to your cell.
Thank you, sir.
An odd fellow, that Macaluso, and with very odd requests.
Bizarre, yes, but to our advantage. We'll make an example of this obsolete man, this actor. We'll show the people how a weak, lowly worm like him dies. So this is your apartment. Not very luxurious.
It ain't much, but it's home.
Ah, another one of your ancient colloquialisms. Ain't.
You know, that word goes way back to colonial times. I learned that from an episode of-
I am fully aware of the origins of the word ain't. Knowledge of its origins does not, however, make it any less archaic or obsolete.
You know, you use that word a lot, obsolete. Kinda sounds funny to me now. Obsolete. Obsolete. Obsolete.
Obsolescence is no laughing matter, Mr. Macaluso. The state has precious few resources. It cannot afford to waste them on useless things.
Like me.
Precisely. If you had had the foresight to pick up a useful skill, such as carpentry or chartered accountancy, you might have led a long, prosperous life.
Those kinds of jobs are never for me. I got no joy out of them.
Joy. Another one of your archaic words. Another reason you are found obsolete. You spent so much of your life wasting time pursuing that purposeless emotion known as happiness.
Not just pursuing it, spreading it, or at least trying.
Making you all the more undesirable to the state. Ah, your guests have arrived. We were very thoughtful in selecting them. You see, while we were searching your apartment for weaponry before the execution, we were very fortunate to have found among your possessions a small robot who proved to be very gullible and very helpful.
No. Scriptobot.
An impressive little device. Wherever did you get it?
Her.
Pardon?
Scriptobot is a girl robot.
Gendering machinery. You really are a pathetic little relic. You even got a jukebox in here. How you managed to keep that cumbersome thing hidden so long, I'll never know. Anyway, your little robotic assistant proved very helpful in tracking down some very close friends of yours. Ah, come on in!
Frank, I swear you're literally the worst. If you weren't about to be executed right now, I'd kill you myself!
Hey, lay off him, Emily. He's had a rough week.
You know what?
Oh my god, you cannot be serious.
You know,
silence! As you can see, we managed to round up a good majority of your cohorts down at that pathetic little radio station of yours. William Barden, Mackenzie Barnett, Emily Bowes, Hannah Hedicke, Josie Hand, Matthew Jester, Yaseline O'Vera, Michael Santos, Antonio Verdera, and Benjamin Woodcock. And, of course, let's not forget your tiny little robotic friend.
Happy birthday!
Shut up, Scriptobot!
Is roll call over yet?
Silence! There will be armed guards standing outside the door. They have been instructed not to let anyone leave this room under any circumstances. Anyone attempting to escape this room will be shot on sight.
Wait a minute, so they're dying too?
That is the intention here. I mean, mass executions get better ratings.
That's not fair. You can't do this.
The state sees no need in being fair, especially to lowlives like you.
Oh, God, I'm so sorry about this, guys.
Don't bother, okay? Just don't.
It really isn't your fault, Frank.
Yeah, it's that stupid robot's fault.
Yeah, what the hell, Scriptobot?
We should have left you in that box.
I just wanted a friend.
Oh my god. You're the worst character ever, Scriptobot.
I'm gonna close the door now.
Ugh, can we maybe turn that robot off or something?
Yeah, do us all a favor.
Well, I hope you all have a marvelous last few hours together. And be sure to really emote for the cameras. They're hidden, of course, but try to give a good show anyway.
Oh, Mr. Chancellor Person, sir, would you like to join us for our party?
As much as I'd love to watch you all suffer and twitch in person, I have another appointment this evening that I cannot miss.
Please? We'll play fun games and everything. I'll make mashed potatoes, and then we can make potato angels.
I'm sorry. But as much as I appreciate your service to me, however unwitting, the answer is no. I'll be leaving you now. This door is locked.
I know! I got us one of them lock you inside doors while Mr. Frank was on trial.
I thought my front door looked different.
What sort of idiocy is this? Let me out!
I hid the key where no one will ever find it.
Well, Sir Chancellor, it appears that you're stuck with us for the evening.
Nonsense! Guards! Let me out, you hear?
It's no use. They're on strict orders not to let anyone out. Your orders, I presume?
No. This is insanity. Tell me where you've hidden the key, tiny robot.
Only if you dance with me.
Never. Dance is forbidden by the state.
Then I guess you're not getting out. You're gonna die in here along with the rest of us. Perhaps you'd be interested in knowing how. There's hidden somewhere in this apartment a bomb. When the clock strikes 9, this whole apartment will be blown to bits, along with everything and everyone in it.
I see. Well, at the very least, it will be a relatively quick and painless death. I see no reason to panic over this development. I will show you and all your friends here and all the people watching that the state has no fears! That the state is strong, resilient! The state is invincible!
I suppose we'll be seeing about that very soon. In about 15 minutes, in fact.
We will now pause for station identification, followed by a brief message from one of our sponsors.
You're listening to WJMU 89.5, The Quad.
Hi, I'm Sawyer Walter.
And I'm Jordan Garrison.
We're not in tonight's episode, and frankly, we feel like it's a disservice, not only to us, but to you, the listener, as well.
If you would like to hear more of us on OST, or, even better, if you'd like for the two of us to get our own show on this station, please write to this address.
WJMU, 1184 West Main Street, Decatur, Illinois, 62522. Attention, Frank Macaluso.
Or call this number.
217-424-6377.
Make your voices heard, listeners.
And now for the second part of our program.
Thank you.
Well, Frank, this is a fine bloody mess you've gotten us all into. You and that dumb robot.
Calm down, Emily. Just deep breaths.
Oh, bite me, Hannah.
Oh, yeah. Using my first real line to get chewed out by you was totally worth it.
Oh, shut up! I should have stayed away from you in college, Frank. We all should have. We should have stayed way far away from you. We should have known you'd drag us all down.
Do you think I wanted this to happen, Emily? Do you think that I wanted you all to die with me? Don't you think that if I could, I would have you all rescued out of here right now if I had that power?
I'm kind of hungry. What have you got in the fridge?
Just some leftovers, Chinese food, maybe some cheesecake.
Any soda?
Are you kidding? That's all I ever drink most weeks.
That's not very healthy.
But it's so tasty.
Anybody got a crap load of quarters?
Oh, I've got some.
Me too. I think I have a couple.
What's the meaning of all this? Why all this inquiry about foodstuffs and money? I do hope you're not under some delusion that the state can be bribed with pocket change and day-old orange chicken.
No, dude. We're gonna have a party.
A what?
A party. You know, one of those big get-togethers
where— I'm aware of what parties are. I'm just confused as to why you're choosing to have one now, when your deaths are so imminent.
Hey, when's the next time we're all gonna be together?
I'm gonna start microwaving the leftovers.
Can I help?
No, thanks, Scriptobot. I think you've done enough.
Hey, I got an idea. Let's do sort of a quarter pool. Like, we could put all our quarters into this bowl, and whoever wants to can take a quarter from it and put it in the jukebox and play some music.
Sounds good to me.
Oh, I don't even know if that jukebox still works. I haven't used it in so long.
Well, there's only one way to find out.
Damn! I haven't got my noise-canceling earplugs with me! Ah, well, I'm sure the state will forgive my listening to music in this instance, seeing as I'm under duress.
You still think the state's coming for you, huh?
They must! I'm a high-level official! They need me!
Right.
Of course! Even if they don't come for me! If, in their infinite wisdom, they see it fit, I remain here and die courageously to show the resilience of the state, I would gladly do so.
First round of leftovers is warming up in the microwave. Soda's on the counter. Help yourselves.
You really weren't kidding, Frank. There's enough soda here for an army. Or at least an orchestra.
Hey, what song do you guys want to hear first? There's a lot of really old songs on this thing. Like mostly 60s stuff.
Play Mr. Roboto! Domo arigato, Mr. Roboto, domo!
No!
Good God, no.
That's not even a 60s song.
Scriptobot, do us all a favor and just shut up. Just shut up for the rest of the night, okay? Please! Not one word more.
Okay.
Is there anything by the Beatles?
No, surprisingly.
Oh, play something by Dusty Springfield.
Oh yeah, she's good.
Ellie's got, like, all of her albums.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
All right. Dusty Springfield it is, then.
Hey, that's some pretty impressive sound quality. Where'd you find this, Frank? Frank?
You okay, dude? Say something.
I'm lonely.
What?
I don't like being alone. By myself. I see no value in myself. I'm not smart like you all, as talented. I know I'll never be a leading man on Broadway. I've got two left feet, a high-pitched nasal voice. That's why I work so hard on radio things, writing things. There's a few things I know I'm any good at. But I don't like doing them alone. That's why I asked you all if you wanted to help me out with the radio station. I'm no good alone. It's you guys that make doing these things worthwhile. Working with you, letting the people see your talent, your immense talent. I'm envious sometimes. You've all got such talent. You're all such beautiful, wonderful, kind, loving people. I love you all. Very, very much. I'm sorry.
the hell?
I think I remember why I haven't used that jukebox in a while.
Where'd you get this?
At an underground flea market. Some old lady in a babushka was selling it.
Well, it certainly does seem to have an interesting effect on people.
Yeah, well, I think that's enough of the jukebox for this evening.
Nonsense, Mr. Macaluso! Need I remind you that, per your request, this whole event is being televised? Let's not cheat your audience, Mr. Macaluso! Let's have another song, shall we? Perhaps something a bit more dramatic.
I really don't think—
I have the ultimate authority here, Mr. Macaluso! I may be trapped in here with you, but I'm still Chancellor! And still your superior! Let me have a look at that song listing. Ah! This one should be entertaining. We've got to get out of this place. By the animals. I can't think of a song more appropriate for this setting.
Please don't.
I'm going to make an example of you, Mr. Macaluso. You and all your cohorts here. I want the people to see you squirm before the might and power of the state! I'll be interested to see which one among you cracks first.
I don't feel any different.
Me either.
I feel fine still.
All cool over here.
This song reminds me of rutabagas.
Shut up!
Well, Chancellor, I guess your little plan to get us to squirm before the might and power of the state was a dud. Chancellor?
I don't belong here. I'm a dedicated high-level servant of the state. I don't deserve to die like this. I've served the state my whole life. Half a century of service, and they would leave me to die with a group of undesirables? Am I nothing to them? I made the state what it is. I made the state great. How could they do this to me?
You're not as mighty a man as you painted yourself out to be. You're just as insecure as anyone else.
Nonsense! I'm not insecure. I know what I am. I'm a mighty man of the state. I'm an important part of the state. The state is nothing without me. Then why haven't they come for me? Is my service insufficient? I gave my all for the state. For the love of God, why won't they rescue me from this death trap? Someone stop this music. Stop it!
Sorry, Chancellor. Once a song gets started on a jukebox, you gotta sit through the whole thing.
Damn this ancient technology! I'll unplug it! Tell me where the key is. I've got to get out of here.
I couldn't tell you if I wanted to. Scriptobot had the key.
Damn you! All right, you little metallic pest. Where have you hidden the key?
I'll tell you if you dance with me.
I will not humiliate myself any further. Tell me where the key is, or I swear I'll dismantle you here and now. Stop that. Stop that at once!
You keep your hands off her. Yeah, if anyone's gonna smack Scriptobot, it's gonna be me.
Wait, what?
If any of you have any sense, you'll stay out of this. Now, robot, where is the key?
Say please.
Whatever gets me out of here. Please, little robot, tell me where the key is.
The key was in my head the whole time. Here you go.
I'm free. At last, I'm free.
Hey, you left the door open.
Where are the guards?
He said there were guards.
I don't think there were ever any guards to begin with. Just another one of the state's lies.
Or maybe they're going after the Chancellor.
That's much less contrived. Let's go with that.
Either way, now's our chance. Let's get out of here.
Right. Grab as much food as you can. We might need it.
No, leave it. It's 8:59.
Shoot, we gotta run.
Frank, aren't you coming?
No. I'm staying here like I planned. You guys go ahead. You never deserve to be here in the first place.
But, Frank—
Go, Emily. Save yourself. It's the best thing you can do for me. Go. Live. Live to the fullest.
But— Goodbye.
It was a pleasure getting to know you, Emily.
It was a pleasure to know you, too.
Did I do bad by giving the big, mean Chancellor man the key?
No, Scriptobot. It was good that you did that. Very, very good. Why are you still here?
Nobody deserves to die alone.
I... Well, there's only 6 seconds left, so... Thanks.
At last, back where I belong.
Halt! Do not take one step further. You have been removed from power and declared obsolete.
Obsolete? I am obsolete?
You have disgraced the state. You have proven yourself to be a coward. You, therefore, have no function. You are obsolete.
But I'm not. I'm not obsolete.
You are obsolete.
Obsolete. Obsolete.
You're making a
obsolete.
Terrible mistake.
Obsolete.
A tragic
obsolete.
Mistake. I am not obsolete.
Obsolete. Obsolete.
I built
obsolete.
Up the state.
Obsolete.
I bring
obsolete.
Glory to the
obsolete.
State.
Obsolete.
I give the state
obsolete.
Strength.
Obsolete.
How can you call
obsolete.
Me obsolete?
Obsolete?
How can you? Please, you're making a mistake. I'm not obsolete. I have a function. I have a purpose. Please.
Silence! Men, grab him.
No. No, please. I'm not obsolete. I've served the state all my life. Let me serve the state, please. Get away from me. I'm not obsolete. I want to serve the state, please. Please don't. Let me serve the state. I'm not obsolete. I'm not obsolete. Let me go, please. Let me go. I'm not obsolete.
No.
We hope that you've enjoyed our tribute to Rod Serling and the Twilight Zone. We will return next week back to our regular format. Until then, good night and thank you. That was Owl Stretching Time, starring Frank Macaluso, Will Barden, Emily Bowes, Yaseline Olvera, Michael Santos, Antonio Verdera, and special guest Colby Jones, with Mackenzie Barnett, Emilio Canals, Jordan Garrison, Hannah Hedeke, Josie Hand, Matt Jester, Mo Mollering, Sawyer Walter, and Ben Woodcock. Additional voices provided by Stephanie Brown, Samuel Leroux, Jason Messina, Mickey McNaughton, Annabella Niewodomski, and Alex Saviano. This episode was written by Matt Jester and Frank Macaluso, inspired by The Obsolete Man by Rod Serling and A Piano in the House by Earl Hamner Jr., and directed and produced by Frank Macaluso. This is your announcer, Jordan Comish, speaking.